Journalist Kemi Oluloyo blasts Davido's first baby mama Sophia Momodo. Child comedian Emmanuella spikes pregnancy news. Jazz fails a masquerade as bullet shots get into him. A 300-level student, Blessing Omaomi Olajide, was allegedly raped and killed at her sister's apartment. Hello, beautiful people. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, please do me well to hit that subscribe button and click on the notification bell so that you'll be notified whenever I post a new video. And for my all-time subscribers, thank you very much as to support your girl. May God richly bless you and support you in your time of need. So let's quickly get into this today's topic, which is about our journalist Kemi Oluwayo, who actually slammed Sophia Momodo, the first baby mom of the singer Davido, for the post she made, which says, "Can someone please tell me why the two of the staff at Dream Supermarket just acted like complete idiots? First, one of them from nowhere just touched me just like that, and then the other one pulled out her phone and thought I would be okay to just randomly start taking pictures of my child and I. How is this okay? I just wanted to get some groceries in peace and go home, for Christ's sake." And this was what Dr. Kemi Oluloyo had to say to her. Mrs. Sophia, almost a Adeleke. One, it was unnecessary to call the employees of Dream Supermarket complete idiot. Two, touching you doesn't decrease your worth or value. You are still a baby mama. I am the grand patron of the Nigerian Baby Mama Association. I have three grown men from two dads. You are one of us. # celebrity baby mamas. Now, what does she really mean by this? For those of us who don't know Kemi, the little thing about her is that she's always, you know, controversial. She's always saying different kind of, as in like bashing people, always like speaking her mind. She's a raw person. Yeah, she doesn't paint us to talk to anyone. What she meant, and one thing I like about this lady, practically, I basically myself, even though she tells you something about yourself, she doesn't, you know, remove herself. You understand? Like now, for example, now, I personally never knew that she had three sons. I thought she just had one son that she talked about recently. I never knew that she actually had three sons from two different men, which she never got married to. That actually makes her a baby mama. So she didn't kind of like just bash her and then say, okay, I'm the perfect. No, she went ahead, told her, hey, you're one of us. I am also a baby mama, so therefore we're all in one club. She didn't discriminate her, neither did she hide herself. You understand? So then, now the third thing, number three, on your daughter Imade is a public figure as a model. She has an Instagram page and happens to be Davido's daughter. You parade her all over social media as dad's favorite, so taking her picture is free for all and no big deal. Instead of bitching about a supermarket, you literally promoted, thinking that you trashed. Change your daughter's page to a fan page, because Judgment Week is going on at Instagram, who is cracking down on kid account of children under 13. At Funny Aisha, my baby had to start all over. Now, what did this number three say? Actually, let's just be sincere. I think on this particular part, is actually right. If you followed, in fact, you mustn't even follow her actually, but you will know that Sophia Momodo loves, like, as in enjoys flaunting Imade a lot. She does. Number one, we have a lot of Nigerian baby mamas from musicians. Let's, for example, ask yourself, do you know who Kiss Daniel's baby mama is, the mother of those twins? Do you know? Maybe. But do you know also who the mother of Timaya's children are? Or also Pato Rankin, do you know who their mothers are? No, you do not. And also Loki, let's talk about Wizkid's baby mamas and the rest that we have. You hardly see them or hear them on social media, but you see this lady, she's always there flaunting herself and her child. But nevertheless, I, to my own personal opinion, I don't think that it is right that this person just comes out right now, you know, to take a picture of the child without her consent. You know why? Because Imade is still underage. Imade still has a mother. And if we look at what on social media, actually what the mother decided to put on there, you get. So that is why we never can tell, or we don't even know how Imade was in that particular situation. You understand me? So it may not be in an appropriate way. Therefore, those employees, they were wrong. Normally, they could be sued. Imagine you're on YouTube, for example. You do children videos. Yeah, you put them on there. Comments are locked. You understand? Comments are locked. Then you, that child, that means the YouTube is actually protecting that child. Why won't YouTube say, no, you brought your child down here, so therefore we can do anything we want to do? No, they won't do that. Why? Because they're protecting that child, because everything we're doing, it's our own will as parents, but it isn't the will of that child. We are deciding. Most times, all these things may affect the child in the future. And that is why I simply believe that what she was trying to do was to protect. But what she did to my own father was wrong, was for her insulting those employees. She would have kindly told them. And maybe, you know, people actually approach you the way you let yourself down. Do you understand? Everyone, I think that she flawed. Like, you can't do that to Timaya's baby mama now. Or or even other Davido's baby mamas. I think we have, like Choma, for example. You cannot do that to Choma. It's not possible. Because of the way Choma always gives that her son privacy. You understand? So when you compare, you will see, I am not saying that what she did was bad in protecting her child. No. But she was actually approached the way she left. She's always catching clouds. Like now, for example, where she just came out from nowhere and said, I remember my mom and aunties laughing at me when I was crying because my daughter's last name wasn't going to be Momodu. Like, girl. In this traditional world, like, we are Nigerians, the world is civilized, I agree, but we are traditional people, we ought not to leave our roots. And it's actually a shame, if not for the so-called civilization, for a child to bear the mother's name. Hey, it doesn't work that way. So that was actually uncalled for. I was genuinely distraught. I was even arguing and everything that they put her father's full name and not a single letter from mine. Pulled out my feminist card and everything. Z. It pained me, gun. That's your sha. Actually, girl, that's actually not necessary. Because that's you yourself. You are a typical Yoruba girl. The name you're having, I don't know her background, so I can't really, you know, discriminate her or anything about her. But she knows her background and she knows that, hey, nobody, like, it won't happen anywhere. Yeah, that her mother will give her. Her name is not possible. So what she was saying was just bullshit. So things like this that she does to get famous or stuff like that is not really necessary. So she's actually one of the most loved or liked baby mamas in Nigeria, actually. So let's read some of the thoughts of Nigerians. I love this woman always, straight to the point and says the truth too. God bless you, man. That is actually now about Dr. Kemi. I like you, Sophia, but I agree on Dr. Kemi with this. You don't pretend or paint word. One thing I love about you, Dr. Kemi. Almost Adeleke. This is a bitter truth. At the same time, dead funny. Then someone directed now to Sophia. Bitter Karen, Sophia. We don't tire for your drama queen parade on social media. Dr. Kemi doesn't pretend. Nice. I enjoy this part of you too. Then someone came out again and brought Choma as usual. Davido's heart is still with Choma because she's down to earth and respects herself. This one will not find self, no go respect herself. Then someone else again wrote, please tell her she's the least favorite of Davido's baby mama. So the comment went on and on. That one came again. Sometimes you don't really have to rant about unnecessary things just to create headlines. Exactly what I was trying to say. Of course, you are more like a public figure. What are you expecting? Daughter, you don't bust my head. Daughter, how I so wish I'm in Lagos at least one day I will have requested for your presence. You too get sense, Jerry. So this is this. So let's straight up thought of Nigerians. I love this woman always, straight to the point and says the truth too. God bless you, man. That is actually now about Dr. Kemi. I like you, Sophia, but I agree on Dr. Kemi with this. You don't pretend or paint toward one thing I love about you, Dr. Kemi. Almost Adeleke, this is a bitter truth, at the same time dead funny. Then someone had directed now to Sophia. Bitter Karen, Sophia, we don't tire for your drama queen parade on social media. Dr. Kemi doesn't pretend. Nice. I enjoy this part of you too. Then someone came at again and brought Chioma as usual. Davido's heart is still with Chioma because she's down to earth and respect herself. This one will not find self, no go respect herself. Then someone else again wrote, please tell her she's the least favorite of Davido's baby mama. So the comment went on and on. That one came again. Sometimes you don't really have to rant about unnecessary things just to create headlines. Exactly what I was trying to say. Of course, you are more like a public figure. What are you expecting? Daughter, you don't bust my head. Daughter, how I so wish I'm in Lagos at least one day I will have requested for your presence. You too get sense, Jerry. So this is this. So let's moment where the magic power failed the masquerade. Please, my people, watch this and drop your comment what you think. Indeed, Jesus' power is supreme. Watch video. Thank you. After weeks of speculation, it's now clear the young comedian Emanuela is not pregnant, as a fan wrote in a recent post. I can't see the belle. I am not pregnant, you can see. That must have been a rumor if you had heard so.
Out there, somewhere far away, I
a 300 level student of Uni Lorry was found dead in her sister's room. The deceased stayed with her elder sister. The elder sister came back from work at about 6 p.m. on Tuesday, saying that she had tried terribly to reach her sister on the phone but couldn't, as the phone kept ringing. She came back from work to make the door of her apartment locked. After several attempts to get into the house, she called her neighbors to help her open the door, where they found the deceased lying on the floor with her hands tied at the back and her mouth covered. That could have explained why no one heard the sound while she was being attacked. There were also bruises around her private part and her mouth and all over her body. A note was also left on her chest written, "Uni Lorry doesn't forgive." This is actually the third recorded incident in the last few months. As a job seeker and graduate of philosophy, Onui Bong Umoren at the Kwanbom State was also murdered a few months ago. Also not forgetting the 16-year-old Comfort Benjamin, who was killed only with 16 years on her birthday. The girl was found raped and murdered in Jos. On May 23rd, photos of the celebrant were shared online with loved ones, asking for her help in finding comfort, who was supposed to be celebrating her 16th birthday. They said she had left home on May 22nd and didn't return. Sadly, on the evening of May 23rd, her body was found at Nasarawa Gwong in Jos North. She had been raped and murdered. Now she has been laid to rest. With all this, we've come to conclusion. I hope you really enjoyed the news update. I'm an upcoming YouTuber. Please do me well to hit the subscribe button and subscribe to encourage and support me. As time goes on, we all will grow together. Thank you very much and God bless for stopping by. Do not forget to like, share, comment and subscribe above all. Thank you. See you all in my next video. Goodbye.